Welcome to the Kansas Museum of History. We are in the Trails exhibit. How many trails can you guess went through Kansas? Well, Kansas is a crossroads of many trails in America over hundreds of years. Both people and animals have crossed over Kansas on their way to or from other places. Many of you have probably crossed Kansas on the trails of today, such as I-70 and other major highways. Today we focus on the Santa Fe Trail. The trail stretched from Independence, Missouri to Santa Fe, Mexico. It was about 800 miles long, and two-thirds of that trail was in Kansas. The trail was used for trade by American Indians, Spaniards, and Americans for many years. However, trade was illegal with Mexico until after they gained their independence from Spain in 1821. Before that, they were not supposed to do business with any other country. William Becknell, from Missouri, is credited with leading the first legal wagon train to Santa Fe in 1821. That makes this year, 2021, the 200th anniversary of this trail.
Why would the U.S. and Mexico want to trade? Money. Traders quickly realized that they could make good money by trade between Santa Fe and the United States. Americans hauled manufactured goods to Santa Fe. The items were sold or traded for items in Mexico. Then the traders hauled those goods back to the U.S. where they sold them for a profit. Traders in Mexico did the same. It was a win-win for both countries.
Early traders used pack animals such as burros or mules. A burro is the Spanish word for donkey. This limited the amount of supplies they could carry. They soon switched to wagons, and the amount of freight they could transport increased, and so did their profits. Conestoga wagons were the wagons of choice. The bigger the better. They were curved up at the ends so contents would not fall out as easily. They could hold up to 6,000 pounds of cargo.
These heavy wagons needed a lot of power to pull them. 10 mules or 12 oxen were often used. Mules cost more, but they moved faster and were a bit difficult to control. They wore shoes to protect their hooves, and they looked like this. Oxen were cheaper to buy, moved slower, but they could eat the grass along the trail, and you would not have to carry grain in the wagon to feed them. Oxen had cloved hoofs, so they had shoes that looked like this. A pair of oxen would use a yoke like this to keep them going in the right direction. The yoke set on their shoulders and their head went through below.
What did traders take to Mexico? The United States had many factories producing items such as candle molds, medicine, fabric, coffee mills, and clothing.
Shirts like these were made of American cotton and manufactured in the U.S. Calico fabric was made in the northeastern United States from southern cotton. It was popular for women's dresses. Cast iron sad irons were produced in foundries in the United States. If you heated them up, they could easily remove wrinkles from women's dresses. And molds were manufactured in the U.S. as well. Homemade candles offered a very important means of light during trail days.
And what did traders bring to the United States? Santa Fe had many raw materials that businesses in the U.S. wanted. These included beaver pelts, wool from sheep, gold, silver bullion, and burros.
Beaver fur was in great demand for men's hats at the time. Pelts were sold to manufacturers back east. Mules were used as draft animals to pull heavy wagons. Mules are the product of a male donkey and a female horse. donkeys and mules were brought back to the U.S. and sold for profit. In the 1800s, Spanish coins were accepted as currency in the United States. To make change, these coins could be cut into as many as 8 pieces. That meant 2 pieces equaled a quarter of a dollar. Imagine wagons loaded with items that in today's values were worth thousands of dollars. Traders made good money. Take a look at these shoes from the 1850s. The shipment was worth $2,400 in St. Louis. What do you think the value was in Santa Fe? The correct answer is $16,500.
International trading between Mexico and the United States continued until the Mexican-American War in 1846 to 1848. Interestingly, U.S. traders called this trail the Santa Fe Trail. Mexican traders referred to it as the Missouri Trail. After the war, Santa Fe and much of the Southwest became part of the United States. The trail expanded to include military freight, mail, and stagecoach routes.
By 1880, the trail officially ended with the completion of the Atchison, Topeka, and Santa Fe Railway into Santa Fe. The railroad track closely followed the trail. Today, railroads continue the business of hauling freight across Kansas, begun by freighters 200 years ago.